What's up guys? Welcome to another video. Matagal ko na naiisip yung ganitong content since yung first video ko. As you can see in the thumbnail and in the title, no, we're doing a PC compatibility guide. So, syempre napakadali namang mag-search sa Google, mag-search sa YouTube ng PC builds, ng PC guide. Pero mas fulfilling, di ba? Kung ikaw yung mismong pipili ng parts. Pero minsan, ang pagpili ng components ay nakakatakot. If you're a beginner, syempre, di mo naman sure kung itong component na to ay compatible sa ibang components. That's why I'm here, to teach you how to know if all of your components are compatible. Syempre, there are websites just like PC Part Picker where you will just input all the components that you will need and it will say if all your components are compatible or not. But that's just so easy. I mean, ayaw ba ng challenge, boy? Syempre, there are issues pa rin when using a system just like PC Part Picker because it's just a system. Mas trusted pa rin kung ikaw mismo ay nakakaalam kung compatible ba talaga o hindi yung components. Before we begin, listan muna natin lahat ng components na you will possibly need when you'll build a basic computer. So first, the processor, which is the brain of the system. The motherboard, where everything connects. The RAM, the graphics card, storage, power supply, the case. Maybe you'll need a CPU cooler kapag walang included sa processor mo na cooler. And also, if you're gonna be overclocking, you may need a more powerful CPU cooler or a radiator. Syempre, you will need case fans if also hindi rin included sa case mo. So let's look at the processor. So syempre, in my opinion, if you're gonna build a gaming PC, the first component that you will choose, in my opinion, the first component that I will choose is syempre the processor. Kasi this will tell you if you will build a gaming, an editing, a workstation. No? You can put more budget on the processor if you're gonna do a workstation PC. And maybe you can put less budget on the processor if you use it primarily on gaming. So let's look at the compatibility of the processor and the motherboard. First is the socket type. As we all know, there are two main companies that create processors, which is Intel and AMD. Intel puts all their pins in the motherboard, which is called LGA. And on the other hand, AMD puts their pins in the processor, which is called PGA. So there are different sockets when it comes to Intel and AMD. You can just look at the website of the processor and you can see the socket type. For example, we have this Ryzen 3 2200G. As we can see, its socket type is AM4. So we know that the motherboard that we will use is also AM4. In the case of this 9th gen i3, we can see that the socket type is LGA1151. So that tells us that the motherboard that we should be using should have a socket type of LGA1151. But that's not as simple as that. We also have the chipset. So basically, the chipset will tell us if it supports the generation of our processor and also if the motherboard is capable of overclocking the CPU, no? For example, so AMD, we have the B350 and the B450. The B350 supports Ryzen 1st and 2nd generation, while the B450 supports up to the 3rd generation of Ryzen. Which means the B350 will not support the 3rd gen of Ryzen, but there's a catch, no? If B350 have a BIOS update na magsosupport siya ng 3rd generation Ryzen, it means you can use that BIOS update so that your B350 board can now support that 3rd generation Ryzen. If lang ah. Pero pag wala, wala tayong magagawa dyan. We also have the Z and X's. Kung may B350 at B450, in my opinion, the B means budget, which means it is a budget motherboard. But there are more powerful motherboards which has a Z and X's. That just means it has more support for overclocking and it has more features. If you're curious kung tinitignan mong chipset ng motherboard mo supports your CPU, you should see if it supports yung generation ng CPU mo and if you want to use your CPU for overclocking or not. So let's look at the compatibility of our processor and our graphics card. So it's just basically about CPU bottlenecking. What does CPU bottlenecking mean? It means if you have a stronger graphics card and you have a relatively weak processor that will bottleneck the amount of power that your graphics card will deliver. Because mahina CPU mo eh. It can process the graphics that the graphics card is inputting. That's why our graphics card is being bottlenecked. So you have to make sure that the processor that you will choose is well balanced with the graphics card that you will choose as well. Now let's look at our motherboard. The compatibility between our motherboard and RAM is in the DIMM slot. So make sure that the motherboard that you will choose will support if you're gonna be using a DDR3 or a DDR4 RAM. You have to make sure that if you buy a DDR4 RAM, your motherboard supports DDR4. Pero sa ngayon naman, the modern RAM that we are using is DDR4. Madalang na lang gumamit ng DDR3 sa isang system. Pero kung luma yung system mo and you're planning to upgrade, maybe you really need a DDR3 RAM. The RAM speed support is also important. Siyempre, naka-indicate sa motherboard mo yung maximum supported RAM speed niya. For example, maximum RAM speed support ng motherboard mo ay 2400 lang. Tapos bumili ka ng 3200 MHz na RAM stick. The motherboard will only output the RAM at 2400 MHz because ganun lang yung maximum niya. But there are motherboards that supports overclocking of RAM. So you can manually overclock your RAM and the BIOS of your motherboard. It is also important to know the amount of RAM slots. So if your motherboard only supports 2 sticks, don't buy 4 sticks of RAM. Make sure that the number of RAM sticks that you will buy can be supported by your motherboard. No. And it is also important to know the maximum memory size of your motherboard. For example, if your motherboard only supports up to 32 gig of memory, you shouldn't buy 64 gigabytes of memory because, as I have said, it will not be supported. Let's look at the compatibility of our motherboard and the graphics card. So it is just simple, no? If yung graphics card mo is PCIe Gen 3, your motherboard should support PCIe Gen 3 graphics card. No? And also, if you're gonna be using multiple GPU setup, the number of PCIe lanes of your motherboard eh dapat sakto sa dami ng graphics card na gagamitin mo. But that's not as simple as that. If you're using NVIDIA and you're gonna be using SLI, your motherboard should also support SLI. And if you're using AMD and you're gonna be doing Crossfire, your motherboard should also support that as well. Now let's look at the compatibility of our motherboard and our storage devices. So when we look at our motherboard, we see SATA connectors. The amount of SATA connectors in your motherboard should support the amount of storage devices that you will use. If you will use SATA, but if you will use NVMe, you should have the right amount of M.2 slots for the number of M.2 devices that you will use in your motherboard. And also, if you're using Gen 4 M.2 SSD, your motherboard should also support a Gen 4 M.2 SSD. It's simple. Let's look at the compatibility of our motherboard and our power supply. So, as we can see in our motherboard, we have connectors. Siyempre, you will need to power your motherboard, diba? We have two things that we will power in our motherboard, which is the 8-pin CPU power and the 20+4. So, you have to make sure that your power supply has both of those connectors. Now, let's look at our motherboard and case. So kung mapapansin nyo, may mga sizes ng motherboard. The standard ATX, the micro ATX, and the mini ATX. Yung sizes na yan ay paliit ng paliit. Meron din namang extended ATX, and syempre, meron din yung DTX na yung bagong size ng motherboard. So you have to make sure that your case support the size of your motherboard, di ba? Syempre, yung bigger cases can support yung smaller cases. For example, you have an ATX case, it can support a micro ATX and a mini ITX case. But, sino ba maglalagay ng maliit na motherboard sa malaking case? Gusto mo ba yan? Ayaw na eh. Now, let's look at the compatibility of our motherboard and our CPU cooler. Syempre, yung mga CPU cooler, both the air cooler and the all-in-one radiator, it has socket types. No? For example, you're using an AMD system, your air cooler should support socket types of AM4. If you're using Intel, your cooler should support LGA 1151 or other Intel socket types. No? You know what I mean? Now, let's look at the compatibility of our motherboard and case fans. This is a little bit tricky, you know? Because there are fan connectors in our motherboard, di ba? But if you're using multiple fans, hindi mo pwedeng ilagay lahat ng fans sa motherboard. Hindi mo masasaksak lahat. So, you'll need a controller or a fan hub, no? Na you can connect dun sa system fan ng motherboard mo, so you can control all of the fans in your computer, no? But there are other case fans na you can control using a remote, just like Rockmatis. It has its own controller and it's powered by Molex. Di naman to sponsored by Rock, pero Rock, baka naman. So let's look at the RAM. The compatibility of the RAM and CPU cooler can mainly be seen kung gagamit ka ng air cooler, no? Kasi minsan, yung RAM height ng pipiliin mong RAM, itatama dun sa CPU cooler na gagamitin mo. So, if you look at the manual of the CPU cooler that you will use, it will indicate the maximum RAM height that it will support. No? Next, we'll look at the graphics card. So, the compatibility of the graphics card and case can only be seen pag masyadong malaki yung graphics card na gagamitin mo o masyadong maliit yung case na gagamitin mo. If you look at the specifications of the case that you will choose, nakalagay dun the maximum length of the graphics card that it can support. Looking at the compatibility of our graphics card and power supply, it's just simple. May mga graphics card na di kailangan ng external power galing sa power supply at meron namang kailangan. So, if it needs extra power from the power supply should have that connector to connect to your graphics card. Now, let's look at the storage. The compatibility of the storage and power supply is very simple. Kung marami kang gagamiting storage devices, kailangan mo rin ng maraming SATA power cables galing sa power supply para ma-power lahat ng storage devices. That's simple. Looking at the compatibility of storage and cases, yung dami ng storage devices na gagamitin mo should be able to fit inside the case. Nakalagay naman yun sa specifications ng case kung gaano karami yung storage devices na pwede mo ilagay dun. Hard drives and solid state drives. Now, let's look at our power supply. No? Siyempre, yung power supply natin ay connected sa buong system natin. Iyon yung nagpa-power sa buong system natin. And choosing the power supply, you need to know the right amount of wattage that you will use. Dito mo magagamit yung mga website just like PC Part Picker. So, if you go to pcpartpicker.com, it's just simple. You will just click this system builder and you will input all of the components that you will use. So, we have an example here. This is a very basic Ryzen 5 system. Kung makikita nyo sa upper right corner, makikita natin yung estimated wattage, which is 254 watts. So, this shows us the amount of power na kukunin ng buong system mo mula sa power supply mo. We can see that 450 watts is enough for this kind of system. And if we're gonna be overclocking, maybe 500 watts can be a good ceiling, no? The compatibility of the power supply and the case is simple. Power supply has sizes. It can be an ATX if you're using a normal tower case, and it can be SFX if you're using a small form factor na case, di ba? So you can see in the specification of the case kung ano yung supported niya na power supply form factor. So yun dapat yung piliin mong form factor ng power supply. Now let's look at the case. The compatibility of our case and our CPU cooler. Makikita mo lang to kapag gagamit ka ng air cooler, no? Yung height ng air cooler na gagamitin mo should be supported by the maximum height of the air cooler that the case supports. But, if we're using an AIO radiator, it is also indicated in the specifications of the case, no? If it can support up to a 240 or even a 360 radiator. Now, let's look at the compatibility of our case and our case fans. Naka-indicate sa specifications ng case kung ilan yung fans na pwede mong ilagay sa front, ilang fans yung pwede mong ilagay sa top, ilang fans yung pwede mong ilagay sa rear, at ilang fans yung pwede mong ilagay sa bottom. But that's not as simple as that. You should also know if it supports 120 up to 140mm if you're using 140mm. No? I guess that's it. Napakadami. Napakadaming components na you have to put into consideration when you're trying to build a capable computer. But that's where the fun. And it's more fulfilling kung ikaw yung mismong pumili and kung ikaw yung mismong nag-build ng sarili mong computer. If you have any more questions, suggestions, recommendations, you can leave everything in the comment section and I will try to answer and maybe create a new video out of that. Kung nagustuhan niyo yung video, leaving a like will definitely be appreciated. If you like this kind of content, consider subscribing to my channel. And again, thanks for watching.